There's a new support tool in town, one specially designed to take care of large chunks of work that are priorities. It's called Jira Service Management. Smaller, quick requests for help still go through the regular channels. But now, the larger work projects have a special support tool all their own. In the past, ABOs reached out to teams for a variety of enterprise services through email, sending requests in Slack, creating requests in Jira, using issue collectors or templates in Confluence, and more. So many requests coming from so many tools. This was making it so unnecessarily challenging to manage and prioritize the requests. Jira Service Management, or JSM, is changing all that. It enhances the request intake process with one customizable portal that allows customers to submit their new intake requests. Now every request is entered and originates from the same place. Request intake is now manageable in terms of prioritization and approval process, thanks to JSM. JSM will only support intake processes and is not intended to replace existing support channels or help desks. Who should be using JSM? Any team that receives large work requests and numerous requests that need prioritization. How does it work? Your team designates an agent who works on incoming requests and communicates with customers. Other Jira users can collaborate on the submitted request with the agent, but the agent is the licensed point of contact for working the team's JSM requests. Additionally, each team will need a project administrator who can access all JSM features and sets up the portal and request types. If your team would like to use JSM, then request access through the QualityNet JSM portal at https://qnetjira.cms.gov/service-desk/customer/portal/2. Requests to access JSM are subject to approval. These are the details you'll need to provide: type of intake requests you will be gathering, who the agents and project admins will be, and standard Jira project configuration questions. Coming up next, a JSM demo by Emma Place of the Atlassian Tools team. Welcome, Emma.
Hi, everyone. We're really excited to introduce Jira Service Management to you all today. This will help people on two sides of the coin, both submitters who will be reaching out to ADOs to submit requests and the agents who are going to be managing these requests that come in. It will help with prioritization, organization, SLAs, approval processes, and we're going to walk through some of those functionalities now. So we are going to start with an example using the HARP onboarding project. This is live in prod right now, but I'll be showing you in our test environment the pilot that was developed, and the HARP team has graciously allowed us to use them as an example. So once it loads, here is the portal. So I'm going to show you the HARP form that they customized for their needs, but you can have different forms that can differ depending on the ADO you are, or the service you're providing. So we're going to use ADO onboarding through HARP. So I'll click on the HARP integration intake. And again, as you can see, this is very customized to HARP needs, but you would have the ability to customize it to your own needs. So I'll enter some dummy data in these forms. And this form is pretty extensive, which shows the level of detail you're able to collect using Jira Service Management. You can notice as well that there's help text below some of the fields to give users some assistance in completing the information. We also have some optional fields and some required fields. For example, CMS sponsor is required, but ISD architect is optional. So I'll continue filling out the required fields. And then we'll have a bunch of checkboxes here. Again, notice that you can put links within the help text. Lots of user-friendly options. And then an attachment is required, so we'll go ahead and add that. And then we'll go ahead and create. Great. So this is the view that users will see to be able to track requests. We'll see as we go on with this demo that any activity that's conducted by the agent will show up here. They'll be able to see comments, any transitions, and be able to check on the status of their submission. So now we're going to move over to the agent side of things. So a Jira Service Management project is like your standard Jira project, but has some additional capabilities that you won't normally see. So for example, instead of a board view, Jira Service Management submissions are tracked in queues, and these are better suited for the way agents work. You can customize these. For example, right now we're looking at all open submissions, so you'll see everything that has not been closed out yet. You can filter it down on the left-hand side here to just unassigned submissions, submissions that are assigned to you, the person viewing the queues right now. You can narrow them down by status, so waiting on me or waiting on the customer. And you can add new queues based on JQL queries, that will give you even more abilities to filter based on your specific team's needs. So we are going to look at the one that I just opened. This QPP. Awesome. So as an agent, you'll see some things look a little different than what you're used to in Jira. One main thing is that when you go to add a comment, you'll have the ability to share that comment with the customer or just comment internally. So the comment internally can be helpful if you're collaborating with another developer or someone else on your team that's working on the issue. If you're not ready to share that information with the customer, you can set it to comment internally, and that comment will not reflect back to the portal view. It will just show in Jira for your internal use. So I'm going to share one with the customer just so that we can ask them to provide some sort of additional information. We're going to click share with customer. Then I'm going to make a few other changes, and then we can hop back over to the portal to see how those reflect. So as an agent, just like in standard Jira, you can move through the workflow. So we're going to click start progress. And we have a transition screen here. We already responded to the customer. So I'm just going to click on start progress. So here we're looking at the agent view that they've navigated to from the queue. So you'll see some functionality that you'll be familiar with and some that will be new to you. So I am actually going to log in as Adria so that you can see how she could potentially work this Jira Service Management request. So the queue view, which we looked at. And she can navigate to this new request. So the first step in this workflow is something that you might not be familiar with, is there's an approvals section on the right-hand side of the submission. So that is a Jira Service Management functionality. It's set in the workflow that you can configure different approvals. And when that approval is provided, the submission will automatically transition to the next stage of the workflow. So this can be really useful. I know a lot of you look for approval from CMS or whoever as part of your work process. So you can see on the right-hand side here that the first step is that an approval is needed from Adria. So since I've logged in as Adria, she'll see this approve option up at the top here where you would normally see workflow statuses. So go ahead and click on approve. And you can see that the status automatically changed to waiting for support. So Adria will continue to move this submission through the process. The next step in their example workflow is prioritized. This will pop up a transition screen where you can say, respond to customer with a message. Great. So yeah, this submission will continue through the workflow until it reaches the complete status. You can add in as many approvals throughout the workflow on any of the statuses as you'd like. And again, this can be customized to fit your team's needs. So hopping back over to the portal view, let me switch back to myself. So this is what I would have seen as the customer. I can see that Adria has added this comment. I can see that my request changed to in progress. So they will be able to see a more simplified, user-friendly view of the submission and track the progress there. So a couple more things I did want to show you is just the customization level. So one great thing about Jira Service Management is the project admins really have the ability to do almost all of the customization. So if any changes are needed in the future, they won't need to go through our team as Jira admins. They'll be able to make those changes themselves. And it really increases the speed of making these updates. So I just wanted to show you in project settings how these forms are developed. So you can see here in request types that we have the two different requests that Harp had configured for their portal. If we click on edit fields, you'll see the fields that they set up with the field help, the option to make it required or not. You'll notice that this display name column, if you click on one of these, you will see that some of these, every field has to be mapped back to a Jira issue, but you don't have to keep the same name in the portal as is reflected in Jira. So this can be helpful if there's a more user-friendly way to word these Jira fields that can sometimes be a little technical to make it clear to the user what you're trying to collect. For example, this is the summary issue field. The summary field in Jira, which a lot of you will be familiar as sort of the title of the Jira issue, but Harp decided to rename that the application name so that on the form, when the user's filling it out, it will be very specific as to what information you need. And you'll see a lot of other examples within here. So another user-friendly functionality that you can use. The last thing I wanted to show on the admin side is that if you're working on the submission, you have the ability to track SLAs. And these can be customized depending on your specific needs. I'll go ahead and show you the defaults. Great. So the two defaults that come with every new Jira Service Management project is time to resolution and time to first response. So these icons will change to show you where you are in terms of meeting your SLAs. For example, time to first response was supposed to be within 8 hours, and we responded to the customer using that comment within 6 minutes. So we did a great job at meeting that SLA. And then the submission has not been completed yet, so we'll see whether they will be able to complete that within the 1 day and 8 hours SLA that was set by their team. You can adjust these time limits. You can add different criteria that you want to track. And that really helps your agents to stay on top of the submissions that have come in and make sure that nothing has been missed. So that is an overview of Jira Service Management. Please feel free to reach out to us if you have any questions or if you're excited to get started and feel like this could meet your needs. Thank you.